The National Conference and the Congress Alliance have struck it right in Jammu and Kashmir this time, and they have surpassed the majority mark of course, going beyond 47 in the 90-member assembly. And there are, of course, very important takeaways of this election, but let me also tell you why this election was historic to start with on many counts. First of all, it is the first assembly election happening after a gap of 10 years. It is the first assembly election happening after the abrogation of Article 370. In fact, there'll be finally an elected assembly in place in Jammu and Kashmir after 6 years. So that makes it historic. Of course, the outcome has also been very interesting. 5 big takeaways. The first, of course, it's a big win for democracy in Jammu and Kashmir, and I'll tell you why. Let me just cite some numbers of voter turnout. The voter turnout in Jammu and Kashmir this time was more than 64%, which was more than 58% last time. Clearly, voters were enthused to vote, and that is because there has been much that the valley and, of course, the region of Jammu has gone through, starting with, of course, the dissolution of the state assembly. Then, of course, Jammu and Kashmir lost its special status of Article 370, and the delimitation happened. There was also, special tribe category status, given to several groups, and of course, SC given to some groups like Valmiki. So clearly, the valley and Jammu have gone through a lot. People were enthused to vote, and which is why it just reflected not just in the voter turnout, but also in the number of candidates. 908 candidates from several parties actually, contested this election. 44% of them were from smaller parties, and also from, they also were independents, which is why this election became all the more important and unique. The second takeaway would be the fact that... The second takeaway of the fact is that National Conference makes a big comeback here, because National Conference, if you look at it, the Abdullahs had a very bad year this time, starting with the fact that Omar Abdullah lost to engineer Rashid in just a few months ago in the Lok Sabha elections of 2024. And of course, while it was going to be not a great year, this really, shows that the NC made a turnaround, because Omar Abdullah, while, he had a lot of back and forth as to whether to contest elections or not, he didn't want to be a chief minister in a stunted assembly. That's what he said. But clearly, he made a decision, a political decision, to contest from 2 constituencies, from Ganderbal and, of course, the other constituency of Budgam. And of course, he is winning from both of them, and that shows how remarkable this comeback of NC has been. And then, of course, we have the other takeaway, which is the NC sweeping the valley and the BJP bettering in Jammu. This is important because this election also showed that the JNK is now divided. It is polarized. So Jammu goes to BJP. BJP has come up as the second most important party with 27 seats. And then, of course, you have NC sweeping the valley, and very important seats like Birwa, and for that matter, even Lal Chowk. So clearly, NC, there is something about NC, Gargi, that we say that this is a party with cadre and representatives in every district. And this is something, this is a message that Omar Abdullah and Farooq Abdullah have given out to their own cadre and supporters, that they are the number one party, and which is why their dominance is seen very clearly in the valley. Of course, then you have... the other things in the sense, of course, independents who have done well, but of course they've not done so well. Especially with regard to Sheikh Rashid's party, Engineer Rashid's party, which has not really performed to do well. And of course with regard to Altaf Bukhari's Apni party, or for that matter, Sarjan Barkhati. So clearly these parties, there was a lot of expectations from them, but of course they've not been able to really give in that much. So these are some of the important takeaways. But most importantly, both LG and the state government will have to now work together. And while there's a lot of expectation that there will be restoration of statehood for Jammu and Kashmir, something that the Prime Minister himself has promised, there, of course, is going to be a long wait for that.
All right. Thanks so much, Vasudha, for taking us through these results in Jammu and Kashmir and what they mean and what makes them so historic. But yes, a resounding victory for the National Conference. Lots to think about for the PDP.